to disassemble, repair and assemble your Samsung Galaxy Note 3, you will need a small Phillips and bladed screwdriver and a plastic separation tool. You can use a spudger, guitar pick or a plastic knife. If you're replacing the screen without the frame, you'll need to use a heat source. Here I have a hot air heat gun. You could use a fan heater or possibly a hairdryer. If your new screen doesn't come with fresh double-sided tape, you'll need to replace it with this mobile phone tape, which is extremely sticky and flexible compared to normal household tape. Make sure the device is completely shut down. And remove the battery cover and the battery, which contains the NFC antenna. Remove your SIM and micro SD card, and using a small Phillips screwdriver, undo all these silver screws on the rear cover. This one will have a warranty seal, which you'll need to remove before you can undo this screw. You can skip this stage, or any other, by clicking Next at the top corner. Don't worry about getting the screws mixed up, as they're all the same size. These contacts are for wireless charging, and these two are for a different type of wireless charging. Be sure to remove the S Pen, and using the thin plastic tool, starting in this top corner, lift the rear cover away, and gradually work your way around the outside edge. The clips are not too strong, so you shouldn't find this too difficult. You might find this top corner a little bit tricky to release, but it will come off. These two silver contacts are for the 4G antenna. This one's for the GPS and Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antenna. If you need to replace the camera lens, lift these small pieces of green tape away, and this will expose two metal tabs which you can bend up with a screwdriver and remove and replace your camera lens. These are moisture indicators which change colour if the phone's been wet. These contacts or for your loudspeaker, and this is the main microphone gasket, and this contact is for your 3G and GSM antenna. If you're having problems with your main microphone or the micro USB and MHL port, you can replace this circuit board. Start by disconnecting the 3G and GSM antenna flex cable and lift this small board away from the casing. This contains the Hall effect sensor. Unplug the flex cable from the main board, and using a thin blade, gently separate the USB board from the chassis. You can make things a little easier by using some heat from a fan heater or hairdryer. If you're planning on reusing this USB board, then be careful not to bend it too much, as it may damage some of the components. If you're replacing it, don't worry too much about any damage. If you're going to reuse this adhesive, make sure it's sitting down nice and flat. These contacts are for the 3G GSM antenna. This is the main microphone, and the sound enters through this small hole. If you need to replace the headphone socket, you'll need to lift the main board up first. This is the forward-facing camera and proximity sensor. You can remove this by lifting this small clip up. When that's released, you can lift this small bracket away. Disconnect the flex cable, being careful not to damage any components nearby, and lift out the flex cable. This is an infrared LED which works with the proximity and gesture sensor, forward facing camera, and infrared blaster. If you're replacing this, you might need to transfer this plastic spacer over to your new one. So lift the flex cable away. And your new flex cable will look something like this. Place the new flex in this way round, and bring the cable down, and if you push down, you'll feel it snap in place. To remove the main board, disconnect this S Pen flex cable. Now disconnect the headphone and earpiece flex cable. And this one's for the main display. Be careful of the components nearby. Now disconnect the 3G GSM antenna flex cable. And lift that away from the casing. Unplug this flex cable for the home and touch keys. Gently lift the main board up, making sure the camera is free and this flex cable is pushed out the way. Here is an external test port for the 3G GSM antenna. This is the geomagnetic sensor and contacts for the 4G antenna. This is the LED flash and background noise suppression and front facing microphone. The sound enters through these two small holes. This is the contact for the GPS antenna and your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antenna. This is the S Pen switch that detects when the pen is in or out of the device, and these contacts are for your wireless charging. These four contacts are for the vibrating motor and power switch. If you're having problems with your main camera, this can be replaced by disconnecting it from the main board. Take your replacement and plug it back in. This is the volume up and volume down switch. These can be replaced using a hot air soldering iron. Your SIM and micro SD tray can be replaced by heating up all of these solder contacts at the same time with a hot air soldering iron. If you need to remove or replace the vibrating motor or the main power switch, use a small screwdriver or a pointed tool to lever the vibrating motor away from the chassis. If you need to reuse this, very carefully pry the circuit away from the casing. To remove the headphone socket and the earpiece, undo this single silver screw. This is slightly smaller than the others, so keep it separate. Lift the headphone socket away from the casing. If you need to reuse this, then carefully lift the earpiece away from the case. This is the notification LED, and if your new headphone socket doesn't come with this rubber gasket, you'll need to transfer this over to your new one. If you have purchased a new screen with the front housing, you may need to transfer this heatsink compound over to your new one. Most new screens come with this already attached. This small rubber cap for your S Pen can be transferred over to your new screen if it doesn't come with this. And this small plastic clip can also be transferred over if necessary. If you purchased a new screen that doesn't come with this metal front housing, or you need to replace the screen frame, home and touch keys, you'll need to separate the screen from the frame. To help do this, you can use a sucker tool. This is from a phone windscreen mount. Or you could use a sat-nav or possibly a fridge one. To help soften the double-sided adhesive, we need to get the screen nice and hot and then use a plastic tool of some kind to lift the screen from the frame. Switch on your heat source and try and get the temperature to around 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. Once the screen's nice and warm, put on some gloves so you don't burn your hands and try to lift the screen away from the frame. If you are replacing the screen and keeping the screen frame, you can speed up this procedure and use quite a lot of force to lift the screen away from the frame without worrying about any damage. If you're keeping the screen and replacing the frame, this is quite a risky procedure as you may damage the display during this process. You can use a guitar pick if you don't have a plastic knife. This can be quite tricky to hold on to with gloves. Here I'm trying to lift the screen away from the frame. It's very slowly coming away from the adhesive. Keep working your way around the edge. If you are planning to reuse the display, be extra careful on this corner, as here the plastic blade is cutting through the digitizer cable. This won't be a problem if you're replacing the display. This is being shown in real time, so you can see how slowly and carefully it needs to be done if you're planning to reuse the display. Take extra care as you come round the bottom, as we have the home and touch keys which are stuck to the display. If you use a metal knife, there's a risk that you may damage the screen or the frame. Again, take extra care as you go around this corner if you're planning on reusing the display. Try not to lift the display too much, or there's a risk that you're lifting the glass away from the display, as you can see in the corner. Again, it's not a problem if you're replacing the display. Between the screen frame and the display is a S Pen mat. And here you'll start to see that this knife is going between the display and the S Pen mat. If you want to reuse the display, then try and keep the knife between the S Pen mat and the frame, so the mat stays on the display. If you're replacing the display, it doesn't matter. As you can see, this is quite tricky to do when you're wearing gloves. Here I'm lifting this screen from the frame. Once the screen is lifted away enough, you can separate the S Pen mat from the screen frame. Here you can see the touch key is stuck onto the display. So keep twisting and lifting that away from the screen. Now that's free. Move along to the other side. And keep twisting and lifting the screen away from the touch keys. And now we can switch off the heat source. If you're going to reuse the screen and the S Pen mat has come away from the display, make sure it goes back on completely straight and lines up with both sides. If this Digitizer flex cable is damaged during separation, then you will need to replace the complete screen assembly. This is the temperature and humidity sensor, which samples the air that comes through this hole. To remove the home and touch key flex, gently lift away from the casing. You can use some heat to soften the adhesive. When removing the home key button, if you want to reuse it, be careful not to damage the flex by carefully lifting the switch away. the cable from this side and then feed it through the case. If you are replacing the screen frame, make sure the new one comes with this rubber gasket for the humidity and temperature sensor. Here is another moisture sensor. And if you have a new frame, you may need to switch the LED diffuser over to your new case. Make sure you swap this microphone gasket over to your new case. If you need to remove and replace the power button, use a pair of tweezers to lift it out and make sure you put it back this way round. And be sure those little tags each end locate into the case. The same with the volume button. Make sure that when you put it back, you have it round this way. And make sure those small tags each end line up with the casing. Make sure the speaker grill is located properly and that all the double-sided tape is sitting down nice and flat. Make sure there's no lumps or bumps that will cause the screen to be raised. If you have a new frame and cannot reuse the existing double-sided tape, make sure you apply fresh tape along the top, bottom and sides, and make sure that you cut holes around for the LED sensors and the camera. To reassemble, start by placing your home key flex through the front housing. Make sure you line up the small holes in the home key flex cable with these small pins on the front housing. This makes sure the keys are located in the correct place. Line them up and push that down into place. Make sure the adhesive is sitting nice and flat. Place the home key into position. Then take your replacement screen and put a slight bend in the cables where the white line is. Peel off any protective coating and feed those flex cables through the frame. Make sure the speaker grill lines up at the top. And most importantly, make sure the home key is sitting nice and square and operates correctly. Check the S Pen and the display flex are not trapped. Push the home and touch key flex down. If you have a replacement power switch, you'll need to put a bend in the flex this way. Then offer it into the casing. This can be a little bit tricky, as you need to lift the power button up while you push the switch down into the casing. When you've done that, make sure the rest of the flex is located and give the vibrating motor a good push to make sure it's stuck down to the casing. Now replace the headphone and earpiece. Remember to use the smaller screw. Now take the main board and gently bring that up, making sure that none of the flex cables are trapped. Now reconnect the S-Pen flex, then the headphone and earpiece flex cable. And the display flex. Reconnect the home and touch key flex cable. If you're reusing the original USB board, make sure it's nice and flat. And place that down into the frame, pushing the hall sensor back into place. If you experience a poor 3G or GSM signal, make sure these sprung pins are high enough to make contact with the antenna on the speaker housing. Reconnect the USB flex cable. Now replace the forward-facing camera and proximity and gesture sensor. Make sure the glass is clean on the inside. Before you plug it in, take the metal clip and place this end in first. Then push it down until it clicks into place. Now reconnect the flex cable. Now take the 3G GSM antenna flex. If you have this green tape, then lift it up and place the cable into the casing. Line this plug up as much as you can. This can be a bit tricky. Keep moving the plug around until you feel it locate and snap into place. Push the cable down into that groove, otherwise it will be trapped by the rear casing. And again, keep moving the plug around until you feel it snap into place. Have a final check to make sure everything's in place and connected before you replace the rear cover. Now replace all those silver screws. Only do these screws up finger tight, or they might snap or strip. Replace your SIM and micro SD card and the battery and the rear cover. And you now have a fully assembled Galaxy Note 3. The digitizer is not going to work because the flex cable was damaged, but I did find that the S Pen still works fine. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give me the thumbs up, and I'll do my best to make some more.